हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर राहुल सिंह, अ होम्योपैथिक फिजिशियन. फ्रेंड्स, रिसेंटली आई हैव रिटन अ बुक ऑन स्पाइन एंड इट्स डिसऑर्डर. बोथ ई बुक एंड पेपर बैक हैज बीन रिलीज्ड इन द ओपन मार्केट एंड दिस बुक हैज बीन पब्लिश्ड बाय द पेंसिल बुक पब्लिकेशन. सो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे आई एम हेयर टू डिस्क्राइब दिस बुक एंड वॉन्ट टू शो यू व्हाट दिस बुक इंक्लूड्स एंड हाउ इट कैन बी यूजफुल फॉर स्टूडेंट प्रैक्टिशनर and the general public who are fighting with their spine related problems. So please have a look. So friend, this is the book. You can see the name of the book is All You Wanted to Know About Your Spine. It is a complete guide to the diagnosis and different treatment of spine disorders. It includes homeopathy, yoga, diet to keep your spine healthy and strong. The name of the writer is also mentioned here. This book has been divided into the different 11 chapters. It includes foreword by Dr. Monica Srivastava, a good friend, and she is a homeopathic medical officer in Gorakhpur. It also includes a biography of a writer, and next section is dedicated to the acknowledgements, and then the introduction starts. I have discussed a small history of orthopedic and the role of the homeopathy and other alternative therapies in the case of spine health. Now the main part of the book starts. As I said, this book has been divided into 11 different chapters. The first chapter, that is Know Your Spine, describes the function of the spine, the anatomy of the spine, different parts like vertebrae, intervertebral disc, facet joints, neural foramina, spinal cord, the muscles of the spine contributing to the structure of the spine and their functions. The second chapter is spinal injuries and the disorders. It deals with the history of spinal disorders, spinal injuries, different spine problems, types of spinal curvatures such as kyphosis, lordosis, scoliosis, Sherman disease, torticollis, and their cause, symptoms and diagnosis. The third chapter describes the different types of spondylopathies including inflammatory and non-inflammatory. It includes spondylitis, bamboo spine, sacroiliitis, discitis and their pathophysiology, sign and symptoms and diagnostic procedure. It also describes Port disease, spondylosis, spinal stenosis and facet syndrome. In the fourth chapter, intervertebral disc disorders have been described including Schmoenoord's, degenerative disc disease and the spinal disc herniation. The fifth chapter deals with the pain related to the spinal disorders like sciatica pain and its pathophysiology and different radiculopathies. The sixth chapter talks about different diagnostic tests performed to diagnose the spinal disorders like history and physical examination of the patient, different laboratory investigations for rule out any infections, x-ray, MRI, CT scan, nerve conduction velocity test, electromyography and spinal tap. So by these tests you can diagnose the spinal disorders. And the seventh chapter is dedicated to the different types of yoga and asana for spinal health. Friends, as you know, yoga is a natural and side effect free remedy for spinal disorders. So regular practice of yoga and different asana leads to a flexible body, a calm mind and a positive attitude toward the life. It also helps you to make your spine healthy and strong. The eighth chapter suggests some tips to keep your spine healthy and fit. It describes the right posture during sitting, taking precautions during bending and lifting, the importance of water intake, the importance of exercise, rest and sound sleep for maintaining the health of spine and your back. In the ninth chapter, the importance of diet and nutrition for spine health is described. The importance of calcium diet and sources of dietary calcium is also discussed in this chapter. You can see the daily calcium requirement as per your age or gender in the different tables. In some tables, the percentage of calcium offered in different food item is also given, which will help you to find out the exact food. The 10th chapter is dedicated to the role of homeopathy in different spinal disorders. Homeopathic medicines are equally effective in acute as well as in chronic conditions of spine and its disorders. In some condition where reversal of this condition is not possible, homeopathy manages the complication of the particular problem and prevent further damage to the joints and maintain the well-being of the patient without any harmful effect on the body. In this section, indicated symptoms of medicine have been mentioned along with the modalities to give a ready reference for the selection of medicine as per the individuality or the totality of symptoms. Some lesser known homeopathic medicines are also included. In the last and 11th chapter, it includes the short repertory for quick reference. In this part, I have included three main repertories for better understanding. That is Boric repertory, Kent repertory and Bogart short repertory. So by referring these repertories, you can find out the exact medicine or remedy as per the symptoms of your patient. So friends, this book does not set out to compete with the standard book on orthopedics and surgery. Neither it is an alternative to any other book related to the treatment of spine and its disorder. This is also not a homeopathic materia medica. My main purpose to compile this book is to give a basic understanding of spine disorders. The book highlights the importance of alternative therapy in spine disorders. It describes the role of yoga, asana, diet and homeopathy as an adjuvant with a basic treatment plan. So friends, I hope you will like this book. You can buy this book with different resources like Amazon, Flipkart and the booksellers. So links for buying the book is given in the description book. Both the ebook and the paperback is open in the market. So you can buy this book from the given links. So I will wait for your comments and suggestions and your blessings, and so that I can take this work up to the next level. And thanks for watching.